This right here. It has to be the single most idiotic moment in the history of cricket. If not at the topmost, then surely right at the top of it. Because not only was the decision made here wrong, not only did it decide the outcome of a World Cup, but the wrong decision was made because the law stopped them from making the right one. So, come join us today in this carnival of crazy at the Stadium of Stupidity, where a law cost New Zealand a World Cup. The story starts from one of the most requested topics on this channel. 2019 World Cup final, England versus New Zealand. England requires 15 runs from the last over, and Trent Bolt decides to get into a groove of a lifetime. He bowls to near perfect Yorkers, that's two dot balls. And now England requires 15 runs from just four balls. The next ball, he decides to change up the length, which is hit for a six. England now requires 9 runs from 3 balls, and Ben Stokes hits the next ball to deep mid-wicket. Guptill collects it and goes for a direct hit, and the ball hits Stokes' bat and goes for a 4. On air, Ian Smith screams, "I do not believe what I've just seen," and umpire Dharmasena signals a total of 6 runs. That's 4 plus 2 runs that they ran. England now just requires 3 runs from 2 balls, and with Stokes on the crease. Now, most of you know what happens next. Bolt continued his terrifying spell, with Stokes unable to hit anything properly, just scoring 2 runs in 2 balls. The match tied, super over, and a heartbreak due to the most absurd of rules. But at least here, no matter how idiotic, the rule had some semblance of a logic to it. But back here, in that overthrow, what went down here can be labeled as the stupidest moment in the entire history of cricket. Not an incident, mind you, just a single moment of sheer, utter, colossal stupidity. It involved a rule called Law 19.8. The run in progress only counts if the batsmen have crossed at the instant of the throw. In this case, when the ball was thrown, the batsmen were nowhere close to crossing. That means only 5 runs should have counted, but more importantly, Ben Stokes should have been stuck on the non-striker's end. Adil Rashid, a bowler batting on number 8, would have had to face the last 2 balls. And a bowler who had cornered Ben Stokes, just guess what he would have done to Rashid. So, here is my question. How the hell did it happen? How could something like this happen in a World Cup final? Did the umpire forget the damn rule? Did nobody bother to check it? What happened? The answer is much more absurd than that. A week after the finals, after being universally crucified for his mistake, umpire Dharmasena gave a statement. "I agree that there was a judgmental error when I see it on replays now. But we did not have the luxury of TV replays at the ground. And I will never regret the decision I made. Besides, the ICC praised me for the decision I made at the time." The statement continued. "One must understand that there are too many things on our plate. We had to watch the batsman complete the first run, the ball being fielded, how it was handled by the fielder, where the throw came from, where it went, and whether the batsman completed the second run. I did consult the leg umpire through the communication system, which is heard by all the other umpires and the match referee. So, we assumed that they had crossed each other. Now, I agree. This statement feels like he's just trying to throw off the blame, and I definitely object to certain statements that he has made. But one thing, above all, needs to be addressed. Umpires, umpiring in a World Cup, had to assume that they had crossed. Why? Why couldn't they go and just check the replays? There are 1001 cameras just sitting there. Go check them. That's it. And here is where the tragedy becomes a comedy. Dharmasena explained, there is no provision in the law to refer this to the third umpire as no dismissal was involved. So, if the umpire suspects a dismissal, he can check it through replays, that's fine. If he wants to check a 4 or a 6, you can check, even that's fine. But checking, if a match-changing rule was followed in a World Cup final, no. That's not done. That's against the rules. You can't check that out. How the hell does this make sense? If you want umpires to adjudicate and you're okay with using technology, then why not give them the authority to check things that they want to check? This is like having a life-saving drug in your hand and the patient is right in front of you, but you can't give it to him because the hospital timing is 9 to 5. Yeah. I also know the most common argument against it, that it slows down the flow of the game. In that World Cup final, those two umpires kept deliberating for 6 minutes to ultimately make the wrong decision. Guess how much time it would have taken to just check the replay. How is this saving time? I can still imagine the situation. 3 people are discussing over walkie-talkies whether they crossed or not. Nobody knows the answer. They are about to make the wrong World Cup altering decision and the third umpire is just sitting there, looking at the replay, letting the wrong decision happen right in front of him. Because the rules don't allow that. Crowning jewel in this debacle came a week after the Dharmasena interview. ICC issued a statement saying that the umpires were aware of the law, but the playing conditions don't allow them to refer such a decision to the third umpire. They certainly followed the right process when making the decision. The right process, but the wrong decision. The right technology, but the wrong application, resulting in the hopes of New Zealand ending up in desolation. This was a story then of one of the most idiotic moments in cricket history, where the right rules, right process, right systems together culminated in the worst decision imaginable. The day common sense died, a sad, miserable, and oh so stupid a death. Thank you for watching this video. I know all of you want a video on the boundary rule too, and it is in the works. But for today, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching.